Hello friends, today we are going to present left indirect inguinal hernia eTEP repair. This is a 64 year old male patient presented with left side groin swelling since last 2 years. Right side was operated 12 years back. Open repair was done at some other hospital. He is known hypertensive but on regular medication. No other comorbidities present in this particular patient. UAG scrotum of this particular patient was suggestive of large left inguinal scrotal hernia with bowel loops and omentum as a content, and there is no hernia on right side. So why ETP repair in this particular patient? Because first is the distance between umbilicus to symphysis pubis was only 13 cm and there was a large indirect inguinal hernia, and right side there was no hernia now, previously operated by open technique. As I always do, surface marking was done. 7 cm from the midline is a line represents the seminal line, and 4 cm below the umbilicus is line horizontal line which represents the arcuate line. And the first entry point was taken as 5 cm lateral to the umbilicus and 3 cm above, and here we have decided to take a 12 mm trocar, optical trocar. This is the left inguinal hernia, so the entry is the first optical entry is on the right side of the patient. So 12 mm optical trocar entry is done. First working port is taken from the line joining the seminal line and the arcuate line at the junction laterally. We have taken a 5 mm trocar from this point. From the first working trocar, we introduce a scissor and division of the posterior rectus sheath along the arcuate line is divided. Then the second working trocar is come through the umbilicus. This is a 5 mm trocar. And then both the hand instruments, one hand the bipolar forceps and other hand the scissor, we started dissection towards the left inguinal region, and the sac dissection is carried out. After completion of the dissection, we introduce the Medtronic Dextile 3D anatomical mesh, large size 16 by 12 cm. We used here. We are using this for the first time. After obtaining the critical view of myopectinal orifice, we introduce this textile anatomical mesh, and this is really easy to maneuver and easy deployment of the mesh. It's a real anatomical mesh which fits into the according to the curvature of the pelvis. That is what is observed in this particular patient. Here during this operation we have used the pneumoperitoneum filter with smoke plume and pathogen filter used for the laparoscopic surgery.